the shape of the line as it rises, and also just counting the rest properly.
Okay, yeah. So when you begin, you're thinking of the shape.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's really great. I like to, with this excerpt, I have in my music, swashbuckling, the search for the ideal woman. That's what Don Juan is,
mm-hmm.
right? It's like some kind of almost existential search for the ideal. So beginning, I think what we want is we want a very clear... so in orchestra, you might actually hear more like in a section playing. You might just hear, you know, but in an audition, which is what we prepared this for, you want to have more of a... You can do it down. Many people do it down. But it's worth experimenting. And then, generally, I think with this one, what are the difficulties of this excerpt?
The intonation and in the high register, and bringing all the different dynamic changes out.
Yes, okay, sure. All correct. And it's easy to say and not necessarily to do. So when we articulate what the challenges of each piece that we are doing for an audition are, it becomes, but just naming what the issues are, what the possible pitfalls are already can help us to overcome it. So even just here in line one, I have right here, possible pitfall, right? We have to nail that. So what I remember is with every one of these big shifts, vibrate the note before the shift, vibrate the note you let go. Because what happens is you get tight in this kind of performance. And why don't you try it really quick, first line, and just make sure every note right before you shift, a quick listening, would draw a tiny thing from. Thank you. against what you would feel. So especially watch out for this here. Right there, but those accents just are always on the little notes, if you notice.
Yeah.
And then later, he actually gets so insistent that he accents every single note right here. And what do we make of accenting every single note? Like, that is so obnoxious, right?
Yeah.
Like, but, so find your direction, and then each one kind of has a little bit of an attack. So, I think notes are good, but when we do the background, I do this, but I'm a little more punchy on that little note. Different, but the first time. is knowing and loving your fingering, because otherwise it's so treacherous. It just is ready to, you know, kind of betray everything. So right here, do this one really slow. So from here, find that I do better from thinking about my right hand.
Okay.
I let the left hand govern itself.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm willing to try one more time. Ba-yum, ba-da. And watch out for this, by the way. This is such a common mistake. We want go for any type of element. because we're so, our ears are so judgmental to roughness, and this is rough though, but you have to trick us into liking it with some refinement, right? So that comes with pure intonation and really clean contact.
Okay.
So starting from here, you got this already better, but I think you need for a string crossing a little bit more awareness of angles. So keeping back with your hand, that tends to be,
yeah.
without any sort of like worry about whether it's going to be in tune or not, just really going for the absolute cleanliness in your hand.
Yeah, like it's like
have two modes. Well, probably I have more than two modes, but this is like one way I like to approach it. I have stop mode and I have go mode. So in there, I would practice stop mode, which is like, you're basically like a land surveyor or something. You're literally measuring distance with a little like mental measuring tape. You don't move from one note until it is like exactly where your mind wants to hear it. And it's a rhythm, no rhythm. And then, when you've done that in that whole passage, then you go go mode. And then go mode, you really don't stop. So you're getting kind of in the feeling of how it would go in a phrase, right? But that has helped, I think, for stuff like this where you have like, that's not a matter of having good hand frame. This is just sort of weird. Like, how am I? Okay, that's not a hand frame you want to practice, right? It's just showing your hand, this is where you go. It's like blocking for a dance or choreography. It's weird choreography, but you have to actually know that choreography for your head. Okay, I just want to know, do you have any particular questions about this exercise? You or audience, anything that feels like it's debugging you or not particular, I mean, other than what they say. Audience, any questions? Okay, all right, bravo.
pitches of the bow, that sometimes will overpower that nice sound. Because that's really general sound, like a very nice, clear sound, I think. And it's getting to us in a way that's very clear, which is just sweet. Okay, so before letter A, this is just a quick tip, because you played a rhythm that's part of your bar. And that was the only thing I noticed. I was like, whoa, that was an interesting, it was probably an accident. Okay. Yes, from the beginning, I think just try this opening a little bit like some kind of like a philosopher painter or something. You're thinking of the expanse of the ocean or something. That's what you're thinking about, Liz. Waves, but not like big waves already. They're kind of far away. So, and I actually have been. So you can do it. You're hearing it in a section. Actually, it sounds really nice when you start on the E string. And having a long, it's almost like you're thinking through the rest.
your sound, I enjoy your phrasing. Couple of, I think, shifting choices that I think make it so that you are bringing up the shift more than the phrase. Just a couple. Nothing about this excerpt that should make you nervous. And then you're thinking, well,
think just, keeping like the focus more of the toe work, I think. Just making sure like, it's very even across. And then also making sure like, consistent profile throughout. And I think I can probably tense up overall, which might be, as a result, because I'm putting a lot of energy in and I'm looking for those things.
So, I think when you start this, try to feel yourself, and this is actually goes for the Brahms too, but I think with the Brahms, it worked, your energy worked for it more because it does kind of flow. And this one flows too, but I don't know, somehow I just feel like it would just be like rooted in the ground, back of the beat. Not kind of putting in energy. Like it's not, we're not going to see you anyway most of the time in an audition setting. And actually, your sound will be more easy, more easily shaped by your arm because there will be a moving target and feeling. So just try feeling like rooted. And then, right from this beginning, feel like, and not to say that you're not playing it beautifully, but just let's try it a little bit to experiment. More floating, and every shift you're trying to make it invisible. And the real word is inaudible, I know. But when I think of invisible, I think almost like gossamer, which means pressure negligible during your shifts, right? We need so little pressure.
highlight our ability to do a frog. You just want to show us the crescendo and show us that you can do it. So consider maybe bringing those into the first. Otherwise, really, really beautiful, beautiful playing. And
yes, just for work.
pause too much, but then occasionally they break. So you have circled notes. I think you already are consciously. So maybe a few too many, right? So maybe if you're going to circle them, bring them out maybe in a different way than just with time, right?
Okay.
Time is the most obvious one, and you're using it very well, but just maybe just a note, maybe not like always do the same kind of time. Or if you're going to do timing, you can do a lot of things with time. You don't have to do the same thing with timing, right? You could take a longer pause or a shorter pause, but you don't think it can work. Now, I noticed the only thing technically was G string stuff, which it's because it's so annoying in the hand, I know. But if you can really just clean that up, that's the only thing that is any sort of blemish on your ear. Let's start from here, by the way, or from here, and let's see if you have a fingering that really works, or if it's is it a finger
like
you start to notice yourself at the tip, just give yourself a couple of notes that give you space.
Like almost like an A2.
Yeah.
So own that.
you're enjoying the harmonic changes, when there's something that we can just tell. It's like when you make eye contact with someone, it's like, oh, this is like an intelligence to an intelligence. Like, I recognize a human right there. And when you are actually just being like mindful of it and loving that harmonic change, my ear can hear it. Whether you did it with a lot of time or a little bit of time. So right here, you like, just try to make the decisions about how you time this based on the harmonies that you love. So and let's just go through it once a little bit right from there, just so you hear it. Not really even feeling things. So if you can just kind of read them, I think that will help. But really,